Hello Aries, how are you? Welcome to my channel star and welcome to your reading. So Aries, this is your reading for the month of October 2021 and this is a general reading. Take what resonates and leave what doesn't. Energies might be vice versa and time is fluid. Okay, also Aries, I would appreciate if you would hit like, share and subscribe and comment on below if you find yourself getting resonated with this reading. I would also request you to hit that notification bell so that you will be notified whenever I upload the videos. Aries, there is an extended reading for this one, and if you are interested in the same, if you are excited to know what your person truly thinks and feels about you, what action they will take towards you, what is a likely conclusion between you and your person, you can go ahead and you can check out the link that has been provided in description box and in the comments section. Okay, we'll also see why you are experiencing stagnancy in your love life and what exactly you can do to overcome that stagnancy. Okay, if you are interested, the links are in description box and in comment section for extended reading. Now, as far as this reading on YouTube is concerned, what I'm going to do, Aries, is I'm going to place a couple of cards over here and they will represent your energy. Then I'm going to place a couple of cards over here and they will represent the energy of the person you are thinking about, you are dealing with. In between, I'm going to place a couple of cards and they will represent the mutual energy between you and your person. Okay. Thereafter, we'll pull some romance angel cards and we'll see what are the romantic messages for the month of October. Okay, so let's get started now. Let's get started, Aries. Let's get started now. We have Empress for you, then we have is Page of Cups, and we have is Four of Wands. For your person, we have is Five of Wands, then we have is Six of Swords, and we have is Two of Pentacles. Mutual energy is that of Two of Wands and the Hanged Man. Okay, let's pull out some Romance Angel cards also. So what are the romantic messages for you for the month of October, Aries? What are the romantic messages for you for the month of October? What are romantic messages for you for the month of October? I'm going to discuss these cards at the fag end. Okay, let's discuss the tarot cards first. So, Aries, you may be dealing with a Libra. Okay, you may be dealing with a Pisces, you may be dealing with another fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sag, okay, water sign, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, and I'm hearing Taurus. If the sign pops up, all the better. Let's not remain fixed on the signs. So Empress, Page of Cups and Four of Wands for you, Aries. Aries, with that Empress card, what I feel is you're embodying the energy of an Empress and you know you're progressing in your life, okay? But wherever you are right now, you're absolutely fine. You're happy with the level of your progress. You're happy with whatever you have achieved in your life, or you are content and satisfied with the fact that you're heading in the right direction, okay? So what I feel is there is a lot of satisfaction, and I'm also sensing there is a lot of growth in the near future that is about to happen for you. So when I talk about growth, I feel like growth in terms of materialistic abundance, but you're also going to experience a lot of personality development. You're also going to experience a lot of growth in you as a person. You will start experiencing that your choices are changing. You'll start experiencing that you want to experience more in your life. You will start experiencing that you want to take more risk in your life. You will start experiencing that, especially if you were experiencing stagnancy, okay, overall stagnancy, especially if you were feeling like things are not moving, okay, you are going to sense a shift, Okay, and that shift is gonna propel you to move in the right direction with a great speed. Okay, I am also feeling Aries that I don't know why, I just heard agriculture. So if someone is into agriculture and farming, or someone is into business related to agriculture or farming, or someone is having ancestral someone has got a farmland as an inheritance. What I'm feeling, Aries, is the crop is going to be extremely abundant over there. This was one random message that popped up, okay, ultimately leading to material abundance. I'm also sensing, Aries, that your network is going to expand, okay, and going ahead, the kind of people that you're going to meet in your life are, maybe you will come in contact with some high profile people, you will come in contact with people who are quite powerful, maybe some government officials or politicians or industrialists, okay? People who are very powerful in their field is what I am feeling. Some of you are going to make some conscious efforts to expand your network, and some of you are, by luck, you're going to meet some powerful people, you'll get in contact with them. Quality people are, you're gonna in next 10 years, at least for some of you, okay, you are gonna be with people who are extremely highly successful, okay. You are visualizing like you're mingling around and partying with very high profile people. Some of you are naturally visualizing like that, like I sit and I party and I hang out with people who are millennials or billionaires or people who are extremely powerful, okay? So what I feel is that some networking is about to happen with some really powerful and meaningful people, okay? I'm also sensing you may meet some authors, or some of you may want to become authors. Some of you are really good with your communication skills, okay? So you are having some long-term vision, and you are fantasizing, I'll not say fantasizing, you imagine you as a part of that big, a very big vision that you have for yourself and your near and dear ones, and you also have this urge to help out people in your community or people for whom you feel sympathy, that can be underprivileged people within the society. You have some sort of vision is what I'm feeling, and maybe intuitively you're feeling that you're calling abundance. Intuitively you're feeling like the kind of abundance that is going to come your way is going to be really massive, and you feel like, I want to share this abundance with people who really need it. I mean, you're not going to share that entire abundance, but yes, I feel you're going to become generous over a period of time. Okay, you're growing, Aries. One thing is very sure is that you're walking down the right path and you are absolutely growing. The best part about you, Aries, is that you listen to your intuitions very well. The best part about you is that you listen to your gut talk. Okay, while making any kind of a decision, if you feel like, no, this is not right, you hold yourself back. If you feel like, if the entire world is against your decision, but you feel like, no, I want to take this risk, I'm going to go and I'm going to take that risk, you will take that risk, irrespective of the fact that everyone around you are advising you not to do that. But if your intuition is telling you to do that, then you'll go ahead and do that. So that's the best about you. That's the best part about you, that you listen to your intuition. You listen to your gut. You listen to yourself, okay? So Page of Cups and Four of Wands. A strong likelihood, Aries, that someone is coming towards you with an offer. Someone wants to marry you. Someone from a long-term perspective is coming towards you. But Aries, you will have your own doubts because you are vibrating at a different level, and whosoever is coming your way is vibrating at a different level. Okay, I'm not saying that they are bad. Okay, but the kind of maturity, wisdom, and understanding you have acquired over a period of time, the kind of abundance you are attracting, you may doubt this person that they're coming towards you because you are abundant right now, because you're amazing, you're looking good, you are surrounded with a lot of positivity. You are coming across as an empress and this person is coming across as page, so you will have your own doubts. But again, before taking any kind of decision, I would suggest that you listen to your intuition and to your gut talk, whether you want to accept, whether you want to reject. I'm sensing that you will have multiple offers, okay? And there is going to be a person, there is going to be one person who is going to be there for you from a long-term perspective, Aries, okay? Someone is coming your way to give you that stability, the much-needed stability that you always wanted, okay? Alright, so let's see what your person is saying or thinking. We have is Five of Wands, then we have is Six of Swords, and we have is Two of Pentacles for you. Sorry, for your person, okay? So, with that Five of Wands, Aries, I feel that your past person, they want to come towards you, but then they are being stopped. They are being, some obstruction, some hurdles are being created. Okay, and this has been going on since a very long time. This person wanted to come your way since a very long time, but then there are some external forces who are creating a lot of obstacles, a lot of hurdles, so that they could not come towards you. Okay, and these external forces were also responsible for this separation, ongoing separation between you and this person. This person is leaving someone from their life. Okay, they are leaving the third party. They are leaving the people who influenced them against this connection. Okay, for some of you with that Six of Swords, I'm also feeling that someone from a far off distance is coming your way. This can be your ex, this can be someone else, Aries, okay? So let's be open-minded, because I'm getting a mixed energy from this. This can also be a new person, okay? Let's not deny that. With the Two of Pentacles, yes, you will have choices. You are going to sense some confusion, Aries, because you will be like, should I listen to my head or should I listen to my heart? Okay, that's, I see a juggle between your head and your heart. I see a juggle between your brains and your emotions. Okay, trying to be rational and also trying to be emotional. Which one should I listen to? Whom should I listen to? My emotions or my brains? Okay, so this is also a representative of the fact that your person, they really had to struggle before they could come your way, okay? Like, this person has faced a lot of hurdle, okay? When they expressed that they wanted to come your way, this person has experienced a lot of hurdle. So, we have Two of Wands and we have Hanged Man, Aries, as a mutual energy. So, Aries, yeah, I told you, right? I'm getting this message constantly. Hangman represents a pause, okay? As much as it represents a different perspective, it also represents a pause in a situation. And someone had decided to come your way, but that situation is paused, or it was paused in the past. And whereas when it comes to you, you are no more entertaining your past. You have paused entertaining your past person. Okay, you have decided not to entertain them. So I hope this resonates. Hit like, share and subscribe and comment down below. If you're interested in extended reading, you can go ahead and check out the link that has been provided in description box and in the comment section. We'll see what your person truly thinks and feels about you, what action they will take towards you, what is a likely conclusion between you and them. Okay, we'll also see, Aries, why you're experiencing so much of hurdles in your love life and what exactly you can do to overcome that. So let's discuss the Romance Angel cards. Let go of the control issues. This is a very glossy card, so don't try to control any situation. Just go with the flow. Allow the situation to unfold naturally. Release your ex. The time has come to clear your energy. For some of you, you definitely want to move on. Okay, so even if they come back, you don't want them, but some of you are still thinking about them. Okay, so the message is loud and clear that the universe wants you to release your ex, at least for some of you. Attraction, you attract romantic love by enjoying these moments fully. Okay, when you are happy with yourself, you definitely attract someone towards you. Getting to know each other, as you reveal your innermost selves to each other, your bond deepens. Okay, so make efforts to know the person before you jump into the connection right away. Alright, I hope this resonates. Hit like, share and subscribe and comment down below. Till then, bye bye.